Nothing quite represents autumn like pumpkin and squash. So today I'm going to be trying for the very first time ever a recipe I found on Pinterest. It is a copycat Panera autumn squash soup, and we're going to try it together. The first thing we need to do for this recipe is peel and dice our squash. I don't actually know the proper way to peel a squash, so we're just going to try it and see what happens. Would work a lot better if I had a big peeler, which I used to have, but it broke, so we're just gonna make do. It's a messy project. These seeds will make a really nice treat for the chickens, so I'm gonna save them to the side so that we can give them to the girls later. I've peeled and washed some carrots and an onion, and we're gonna go ahead and chop those as well. So now I'm just gonna have you come over here with me and we're gonna start cooking this down in our Dutch oven. We're gonna throw in a little bit of butter and get that melting down. And then we're gonna put in all of these nice, beautiful veggies that we just chopped up. Now I'm gonna add in the spices. The first one up is curry powder. Like I said, this is a Pinterest recipe, so I will link that recipe below. If you'd like to have the exact measurements for everything, you can just head over to that link and get the recipe. We're gonna add in the maple syrup. All right, so this recipe calls for vegetable broth. I don't have vegetable broth on hand, but I do have this chicken bone broth that I just made yesterday from some of our own homegrown chickens that we did right here on our property. So I'm gonna go ahead and use that, but just so you're aware, the recipe is for a completely vegan vegetarian soup. I'm just changing it up a little tiny bit. This is a beautiful gelatinous bone broth, and that's how you know it's gonna be really good. It just adds an extra layer of nutrients and nourishment to this soup, and I'm all about that. Now we're gonna add in some apple juice. You could also use apple cider. All right, so this autumn squash soup has been simmering away for about 25 minutes. Everything looks nice and soft and like it is cooked down, which is what we want. So we're gonna go ahead and use our immersion blender and we're gonna blend this all together now. So now that we have this all blended up, we have one more thing to go in and that is coconut cream. So I'm gonna put that in and just give it a little bit more of a blend and then we're gonna see how this tastes. The moment we've been waiting for. I'm gonna give this a try and we're gonna see how it compares to Panera's autumn squash soup. It's pretty hot though. I'm not gonna lie, I don't love it. It really has no flavor. It's kind of disappointing. That's okay. We're gonna fix it. I think this is my first Pinterest recipe we filmed where it didn't turn out very good. This tastes nothing like autumn squash soup from Panera Bread, to be perfectly honest. It's missing a lot. All right, let's get the spices back out and we're gonna fix this up. All right, so first of all, I don't taste the sweetness in this at all. And autumn squash soup is supposed to have like that kiss of sweetness that you really notice. You don't want it to be so sweet that it tastes like a dessert, but you do want to notice the sweetness. So instead of putting more maple syrup in, I think I'm going to go with the coconut sugar. I think that flavor is going to really complement the squash. So I'm just going to pour some in. It's probably about 1 or 2 tablespoons. Now, another thing you really notice with the autumn squash soup is the curry flavor. When I tried the autumn squash soup at Panera Bread, that was the first thing I noticed was that it had not an overwhelmingly strong curry flavor like you're eating Indian food, but you definitely knew that you were getting curry. So I'm gonna put way more curry powder in. Probably another like 2 to 3 teaspoons, so maybe like a tablespoon. We're not really gonna measure because we're gonna do this off of taste. But just to give you an idea, let's start with 2 teaspoons. And of course, this would have tasted better if we cooked all of these seasonings at the beginning and let them bloom, but we were trying to follow the recipe. So now we know better. Next time I'll do way more seasoning at the beginning. I'm also gonna put in more of the cinnamon. And of course, more nutmeg, because truly, I really didn't taste any of the seasonings in this. All right, let's stir this up. And I think it's also gonna need the rest of my can of coconut milk. I don't think it's creamy enough. So I'm just going full rogue here, but that's okay. If you make something and you don't like it, you haven't committed to having to eat it that way. Just make it the way you like it. All right, let's see. Do I want to put the whole rest of the can in? Let's go for that. Do it? All right, my husband says do it. We're gonna put it all in. I'm gonna throw this back on the stove for 1 minute just to make sure that those flavors are fully combined. So let's go ahead and do that. I don't spill it. That'll probably be good. All right, let's try this again. All right, take 2. That's much better. He needs more salt. He needs more salt, a tiny bit more curry, and I think it'll be perfect. Let's try it. And what the heck, let's do a little bit more cinnamon. So if we would have bloomed all of the spices right from the beginning, more than what the recipe called for, I think it would have been perfect. I don't think we would have needed to add even more just now. Because when you bloom the spices, when you have them cooking in the fat, in the butter, or the oil, whatever you're using at the beginning, that really enhances the flavor of the spices. So I think if we would have started with a couple tablespoons of curry and a tablespoon of cinnamon right from the beginning, that we wouldn't have needed to add even more just now at the end after I tasted it again. I think it just, the spices weren't quite as strong because I was putting them in after the soup already cooked. So just a heads up. All right, let's try it again. Much, much better. I definitely get all of the flavors now. It's got like that hint of warmth in the back, that warm note that you get from the curry and the cinnamon, and then the sweetness from the coconut milk and the coconut sugar. So much better. This is what autumn squash soup is supposed to taste like. Now I'm gonna go get a bowl, I'm gonna serve it up, and I'm gonna eat this for lunch.